So we're now in gallery 225, and we're looking at a painting called Last Flowers by Jules Breton. I should say that more French. I'm sorry. Jules Breton? Would we call it?
Sounds good.
Jules Breton?
I'm not even going to try that.
Okay. So this one is not explicitly, I mean, I guess the last one was not explicitly Christmas either. This is just like winter, basically.
Right.
But I kind of was thinking this had the makings of potentially like a good Hallmark Christmas movie, even. Oh, so we should describe it. I've done a bad job at that. Okay. So what is happening in this painting is we have this woman, and she is walking in the snow in a garden, which we presume is her garden, and she is trimming flowers that she sort of collected around her waist. She's got some sort of little, like, what do you call that thing?
I don't even know. That's true. I can't figure out
what kind of
pouchy,
apron-y thing. Yeah. You know, it's like tied around her, but she's able to kind of collect all these flowers in it. So I guess the idea is like these are the last flowers that are probably going to grow for the year, is how I've always interpreted the title. I don't know. But I feel like if you were to make a Hallmark movie about this, she is a real headstrong businesswoman, right? She deals flowers. She sells flowers.
Sure. You know, I hear you. I'm going to fight it. And again, I'm going to go more conventional.
Okay.
Just because I'm willing to stick with the 1890 time period here, and just the idea that she's collecting these flowers. And again, we can see that there are flowers that are covered with snow. So she's finding, again, just those perfect buds that still have their color, that haven't completely been touched by the snow. She's collecting them. She's going to bring them back into the house. I don't want to see her as the owner of the garden. I think she works for the family that owns the house.
I'm trying
to grounds of with the garden.
If we go that route, I think this is could be the like culmination of like, this is the like a big pivotal moment in the movie where she is collecting her precious last flowers that she was going to use for something else, but she's going to use them to like decorate the tree at the orphanage or something.
Right. I'm totally with you on that.
Like this needs to be like a sacrifice for the good of others.
Right. Yeah, I was thinking it was kind of like the choice between collecting these and them just going to the old mistress of the house.
Oh,
and she instead says, you know what, no, the old ladies own this house, the flowers are hers, sure, but let's take them to the orphanage or take them somewhere.
So she's like the help who like goes out and there's a very demanding Maggie Smith type who...
Maggie doesn't need the flowers.
That's true. That's who's upstairs kind of like, Primrose, where is my primrose? You know, something like that, you know?
No, she's taking them out. And maybe not the orphanage, because I can't imagine kids in an orphanage really caring that much about flowers. But they're going somewhere. I don't know. The parish nearby or some other family that... you know, doesn't have gifts, and this is their opportunity to get something that reminds them of the beauty and love of the season, that kind of thing. And of course, now I'm also thinking I've seen way too many comic book films or whatever, because I'm kind of like, wow, what if the flowers had like powers that could somehow do something?
We can go there. Like, it could. Like, you could. Like, that might be the more interesting way.
Yeah, because again, I keep looking at them, and again, the colors stand out. So, yes, there should be something more meaningful that you're going to get out of these flowers than...
These are magic Christmas flowers.
Yeah.
Ooh. Okay, I'm onto something now. Okay. She meets somebody or figures out this way that a flower can be transformed into, like, a gift or a wish.
Yes. I'm totally down with that.
So, like, that, like, she can basically kind of Amelie her way through, like, this, like, town or something by, like, helping
Beautiful.
People.
And it's the town.
Yes.
It is the town. She is not necessarily taking it to one place, but she will go maybe house by house, and each family in the house gets whatever they need.
Maybe the sacrifice is also more about like that she needs something and she's not using them for herself, you know? But then at the end, the townspeople come together for her or something, you know, like you have something like that where
and again, a little it gets us back to the overall traditional kind of spirit of things.
Right, everybody comes
back and it's like, wow, thanks to your flowers, we've gotten what we wanted or what we needed for the season.
Yeah.
And we want to give you something back to warm your heart as well.
Okay, that might work on me. Like, I'm a sucker for, like, gratitude in movies. I don't cry at death, but gratitude, I will totally cry at.
All right.
Bowing to hobbits.
That'll get me.
I'm
feeling this one. I'm surprised that I'm saying this, but no, I'm feeling this
idea.
I like
magic flowers that turn to gifts.
Yeah.
Like, I think that's definitely the way to go with this one. Also,
wow. Yeah,
like, we needed more magic, so, like, that's totally...
There
like,
you go.
A little Christmas magic. All right, last flowers.